Once again, I am back in Wadi Salam, the Valley of Peace, the world's oldest and largest cemetery in the holy city of Najaf, the city of Imam Ali himself. This is among the most beautiful places on earth. More than 70,000 prophets are buried in the sacred soil, the most prominent shrine being that of Janabe Saleh and Janabe Hud alayhis salam. Today, I am going to talk about a very unique stone. It is called the Durr-e-Najaf, which literally means the pearl of Najaf. It is referred to as a pearl because it is formed when the rainwater mixes with the sanctified soil of Wadi Salam. This stone, the Durr-e-Najaf, is found exclusively in Wadi Salam. So in a certain way, its formation is similar to that of a pearl's. Apart from that, soil and water are the very materials with which God created our forefather Prophet Adam. So whenever it rains, the dwellers of Najaf rush to Wadi Salam, and the Durr-e-Najaf can be found pretty much scattered all over the place. I have had the opportunity of being in Najaf on a rainy day. It was the last day of my ziyarat in 2013, and there was so much mist that even standing inside the holy shrine, I could only vaguely see the dome. I came to Wadi Salam with a friend that day, and after searching for a while, I managed to pick up a few stones myself. Believe me, buying a Durr-e-Najaf in the market is one thing, but finding one in Wadi Salam is another. So what is so significant about the stone? Allama Majlisi has mentioned in his book Tehzeebul Islam that Imam Jafar Sadiq narrated to one of his companions, Mufazzal bin Amr, the author of the famous book Tawheed, and he said that the very sight of the stone is a delight for the mu'mineen, and it is also a relief from the pain of the eye. He then goes on to say that he wants every believer to have 5 rings: Yaqut, the ruby, Firoza, or the turquoise, Aqiqa Yamani, or the agate of Yemen, Hadide Chini, or the gunmetal, the stone that Imam Ali used to wear during battles, and of course, the Durr-e-Najaf. The Imam says that the person who wears this ring, the Durr-e-Najaf, every time he glances at the stone, he gains the reward of 1 Hajj, 1 Umrah, and 1 Ziyarat. I had heard this hadith from my mother as a small child, that Imam Jafar Sadiq had said that had God not been merciful towards the Shia, every gem of Durr-e-Najaf would have been costly, but it is out of his mercy that he has made it easily available so that the rich and the poor may wear it alike. It is believed that each gem of Durr-e-Najaf is born in a spot where Imam Ali had at some point stepped foot. In short, Durr-e-Najaf is a stone that is born out of the dust of Imam Ali's footprint. Sultan-e-Din ke faiz se kya kya sharaf mile, chhani jahan ki khaak to Durr-e-Najaf mile. In the following parts of my documentary on Durr-e-Najaf, I will tell you about the various attributes of the stone and also narrate some historical events related to it. I will also take you around the markets of Najaf, where a genuine Durr-e-Najaf can be bought. To sign things off, I was joined by an old friend later that day, and we continued to explore Wadi Salam, the Valley of Peace, but only as much as one possibly can in a day. Before long, it was evening, a symbolic evening in more ways than one. The curtains were coming down on my ziyarat of Arba'in 2016, and it was my last night in Najaf. Even the birds were headed home, flying away into the sunset. It reminded me of a beautiful saying of Imam Ali, peace be upon him. He says, "Learn to have faith like the birds, for when they return to their homes in the evening, they do not carry the sustenance for the next day in their beaks." So, here I am, learning from the birds, that every land is my land, every ocean is my ocean, every language is my language, and every people are my people, because I am a citizen of the world. Oh, Wadi Salam, the valley of peace, Najaf, the holy city, the city of Imam Ali himself.
لفت إلا عليلا سيف إلا ذو الفقار لفت إلا عليلا سيف إلا ذو الفقار
Change document, Wadi Salam, it's not easy, but it's very serious problem.